Hi, Ray Phoenix here again. This time I'm playing Bust a Move, the original Bust a Move on a Neo Geo MVS arcade cabinet, possibly the largest gaming system ever made. This is Bust a Move, a game that's interested me a lot over the years. What interests me is it's like Tetris, or somewhat like Tetris, like that kind of puzzle game. What's interesting is it seems so much simpler. You just simply aim an arrow around and you shoot at colored bubbles and you make them pop. It seems like such a simple thing, but a lot of times I actually find Bust a Move to be a lot more fun, actually, than Tetris. I think it's more fun to simply just go and blast it and use elaborate techniques to shoot things at edge. I obviously failed there, as you can see, but that's because I'm playing the game using one hand. I have one hand to fire the button, press the fire button, and one hand to move the thing left or right. I only do it with one hand, which is kind of a hard thing to do. You might even be impressed if you see my gameplay. Are you being impressed I was able to do this one-handed while I've recorded with the other hand? So, yeah, because the only way to record these arcade machines really is just simply to film them. Nothing more, nothing less. So yeah, Bust a Move. Bust a Move is a series that I've quite... like, I actually kind of prefer its alternative title, Puzzle Bobble. Bust a Move sounds more like a dancing game or a song by Young MC, but this is more like a puzzle bobble game. It also sounds similar to Bubble Bobble, which I think this game stars Bub, which also appears, he's that dinosaur guy at the bottom of the screen. I think he also appeared in Bubble Bobble, which is also made by Taito, I think so. I guess that plays out. The first Bust a Move game I ever owned was Bust a Move 4 on the Sega Dreamcast. I spent countless hours playing that game over the years. It intrigued me that there's so many different characters in it, and they all do these different things. Of course, this is the first game, so this doesn't have any of that. But it just intrigues me that a game as simple as this could be so much fun. You know, it could have so much great fun in it. I wish this game, more people knew this game. I mean, I think this game does deserve the same recognition as games like Tetris or to be known as a classic. Everyone knows Tetris, right? Even people who don't play games or don't follow games know what Tetris is. But I believe this game deserves that same kind of recognition. Because, like I said, it really is that fun. I really think this is a very good game. I really would like to see more games like this and more... which I think there are more games like this, yes. So yeah, I've also collected Bust a Move 2 on the N64. I also got the PlayStation 1 version of Bust a Move 4 because I thought my Dreamcast died at one point, which it didn't, because I fixed it, thankfully. And yeah, it was, I collect these games. I do think they're really fun. I also have the original Puzzle Bobble. I have a ROM of the original Puzzle Bobble on the Super NES, which I made a video of that many months ago of me playing. Again, I played it one-handed. I didn't really have because my recording software at the time broke, so I could only film the screen with my hand. And I played it one-handed. Again, you have to give me credit for that. I'm able to play something one-handed, something intended for two hands, being played one-handed. So, yeah, that's kind of it. I mean, it's not that hard of a game. It's not like an action game where you have to punch and attack things this and during a fighting game. Like, come on, I'd envy anyone that could play Street Fighter 2 one-handed, or better yet, maybe even no-handed, just to their face. I'd love to see someone do that. Anyway, so yeah, this is, I've been doing these commentary videos now, because I believe they're more fun than what I've done before. I just simply play the game. I'm glad I've been getting a bunch of subscribers, too. And I'm glad that, Solar Farrell, I think that's her name, Solar Fall, the beauty queen. I want to thank her for subscribing to me, and I want to thank her too for watching my video of Socky the Sock Puppet talking about Tammy Newborn. I'm glad that she that you watched the videos, and I thank you for that. I also will be making more of those blog videos where I use my sock puppet to talk about funny stuff and the future, and talk about my rivalries and the funny people I come across on YouTube, the ones that want to kill me over ridiculous things like 4Kids or anime dubs. I don't even care much about anime. I never even liked anime at all, really much. I understand a lot of people like it, but I don't particularly like it per se, but I definitely like 4Kids. I mean, I grew up watching 4Kids TV and the Fox Box and Saturday mornings, back when Saturday morning cartoons were still a thing. Which is pretty much a thing nowadays, along with TV itself. Now that more people are watching stuff on the internet, I should know, because I'm one of them. I watch almost everything on the internet nowadays. I'm an internet-holic, basically. I just watch cartoons that people put on YouTube. Like, I'm glad to see a lot of the old cartoons actually are on the internet somewhere. I'm glad to see people still remember the good cartoons. I'm glad to see people even still buy these arcade machines and have these retro vintage arcades set up. I'm glad to see people appreciate classics. I like people that appreciate classics. I think that's some... very good. Like that Solar Farrell, the beauty queen, I think that's her name, that described to me. They upload a lot of stuff about about like old video games and stuff. Like just the other day, I watched the gameplay video of Itchy and Scratchy Golf. I said, yeah, Itchy and Scratchy playing golf. I totally remember that from The Simpsons. That was the most memorable Simpsons episode ever. That's better than Who Shot Mr. Burns. It makes Who Shot Mr. Burns look like something a kid drew and made. It really was that. It was that good. And the music in that game was so awesome, too. These are the exact same music from the show, too, that we're all familiar with, the old Grammy-winning music. That's really good. I am quite a fan of The Simpsons. I just recently bought a bunch of Simpsons on DVD, where a funny mistake happened, where I bought Simpsons Season 8 on DVD. I got the box of Season 8 of The Simpsons on DVD, but I opened up the box instead. There's a manga of My Hero Academia inside of it instead. How did that such a mistake happen? I don't even like manga at all, Rami. As I said earlier, I don't really like this stuff at all. I was very pissed that I didn't get my Simpsons Season 8. That's the episode where Homer discovers Mr. Sparkle. That's a season that has Mr. Sparkle in it, where Homer sees his face is on a box of Japanese dish detergent. How did my face get on a box of Japanese dish detergent? I mean, I'd be pretty freaked out if I found my face on anything, really. Even if it wasn't Japanese dish detergent, even if it was an American dish detergent you could buy in stores, if my face is on one of those, I would be pretty freaked out. It also had the episode that had Frank Grimes in it, one of my favorite episodes, where Frank Grimes is disgusted at Homer Simpson for the fact he's achieved so much. Imagine he's an idiot. Like, come on, that's how it is in real life. A lot of people slack off and they still do well. It's actually becoming quite a thing, actually, for slackers to prosper. I think it's all good and all fun, and I think this is game over now. Yeah, this is game over now, so I'll be signing up. Ray Phoenix signing up. Have a good day, everyone.